This is the Von Smithman Museum. It was built in 1847 as a school, and it has never been a home. It served Selma throughout its whole life. It's been a Confederate hospital, a Freedmen's Bureau hospital, the Dallas County Courthouse, a Presbyterian Military School, and the Von Memorial Hospital from 1911 until 1960. So it's been integral to Selma's history. We don't really know who the ghost is, but there have been several things that have happened. Maybe with it being a hospital so many times, it wouldn't be hard to see a ghost in here. They've heard footsteps coming down the stairs. The toilets flush by themselves occasionally, and the elevator runs by itself. Now, personally, I have heard footsteps on the third floor with nobody up there. It's a hardwood floor. That floor is where we recreated the hospital. It sounded to me like 1930s nurse. It was sounded like female footsteps, the kind with the bigger heels, like a nursing shoe would make. And there was nobody there. And when I first started working here, this is the one that really gets me. Joyce Smith, the woman who was training me, was taking me around and showing me all the artifacts that we have and the displays. And we got to the picture of William Rufus King hanging on the wall there. And she asked me what I knew about it. Well, I grew up in Selma, so I knew that he founded Selma and he'd been a United States Senator and ambassador to Russia, Naples, and France, and that he had been elected Vice President. Well, I got a little sarcastic since it was just the two of us talking. And I said, well, he was Vice President for about 2 weeks. And the second I said that, the glass globe in the lamp, it's like somebody picked it up and slammed it back down into its setting. And I leaned, first I took a step back, and we both did. And then I leaned in and I said, I am so very, very sorry. I promise I will never do that again. And then for about 2 or 3 months, when I walked in the door, I always said, good morning, Mr. Vice President. And then they have what they call a K2 meter that measures electrical magnetic impulses. And we were in one room and it would light up in response to questions. And it was consistent. We would ask, it always lit up when we asked certain questions. When we would change it a little bit, it wouldn't light up. It never messed up. But whoever it is somebody that really likes this building. And actually, when the ghost hunters first came, I got here early and I stood out here. I said, now look, if you're here, it would be really nice if you came out, because this is going to help Selma and it might bring people to this museum. And that's when we had the lights light up. And one of the investigators said the ghost's name was Janie. And she was young. She was lonely.